जनरल स्टडीज पेपर थ्री इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी। सो जनरल स्टडीज पेपर थ्री बेसिकली कंप्राइजेस द फॉलोइंग यूनिट्स: इकोनॉमी, एग्रीकल्चर, साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड एनवायरनमेंट, इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी, डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट अ डिस्कशन ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन, व्हाट आई वुड एडवाइज ऑल ऑफ यू इज कीप गोइंग थ्रू द सिलेबस अगेन एंड अगेन। सी फॉर इंस्टेंस, नाउ वी हैव स्टार्टेड अ टॉपिक ऑन इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी। You see what topics are covered in internal security. So you keep going through the topics, you will have an idea of the syllabus, and the more the number of times you read the syllabus, you become proficient in the syllabus and what it is. So that why I'm repeating this is, since the time is limited for the mains, and knowing the syllabus, knowing the topics will help you from, or it will prevent you from straying into unwarranted, unnecessary areas. So General Studies Paper 3, Internal Security. Today we do a topic on mob violence, mob lynching. You see the question first. The act of providing instant justice is nothing but in itself a serious crime. In the light of the statement, examine the issue of mob lynching and suggest solutions. 200 words. So the answer for this question, I have split it up into with an introduction. Then what are the factors contributing to mob lynching? This you can give about 3 to 4 lines, 4 sentences. The bulk of the answer would be examining the issue of lynching and suggesting solutions. So you go with an introduction to this particular topic, mob lynching. So mob lynching is a national phenomenon. This points to a breakdown of the role of law in several states. So basically, what do we understand by mob lynching? See, like we may have seen in the social media, suddenly there are rumors that somebody is guilty of child lifting, or somebody is guilty of smuggling cattle for beef, offending the Hindu sentiment. So these stray incidents coupled with the social media, which tends to ignite the issue, which tends to derive pleasure, or which is not responsible, all this aggravates the situation. So stray incidents coupled with the irresponsible social media contribute to increasing violence caused due to mob lynching or related to mob lynching. So when we see the statistics, Assam accounts for the highest incidence of mob lynching. Mob lynching can be attributed to several factors. The first one, obviously, the political leadership. See, the political leadership is itself, irrespective of whichever party is in power, is playing a role in the mob lynching, in provoking the mobs and fanning the violence, obviously for their own ends. The second thing would be police inaction. Police not taking any action when the case of mob lynching is reported to them, or police waiting for directions from their superiors. Strict police. Simply put, police inaction is another factor which aggravates the situation. The third thing is popular perception. See, by popular perception, I mean people want instant justice. See, there is a popular perception. The people believe that the offenders, say in a rape or child lifting or cattle smuggling, will be left off the hook due to the procedural delays in the judicial system. So they want instant justice. The public wants to punish the perpetrators of crime. This is popular perception. This is another reason for mob lynching. Social media, WhatsApp, and other forms of social media or also aggravating the situation. See, in any case of the mob lynching, say suppose a child lifter, the social media adds to the confusion by fueling rumors which will further aggravate the situation. So the first part of the answer, the issue of mob lynching, you analyze the four factors: political leadership, police inaction, popular perception, social media. Come to the solutions. So if the answer would be, you can break up the answer into two parts. The first part would be the factors responsible for mob lynching. The second thing would be the solutions. So the first important thing would be, we should have a specific hate crimes law on the lines of the Communal Violence Bill. See, some time back there is a Communal Violence Bill which is still pending in Parliament. So this Communal Violence Bill is a very radical bill in the sense that if there is inaction on the part of the bureaucracy or on the part of the police, they can be held responsible. So a specific hate crimes law. The second important thing would be, this you can give more importance, implement directions of the Supreme Court. See, the Supreme Court had given a 14 point directions on mob lynching. See, what the Supreme Court said was, each district, you nominate a senior police officer to take measures. You identify the districts which are prone to mob lynching. By district, I mean the subdivision, the villages, everything. So this senior officer who is in the district will monitor the instances where they are periodically occurring. He will go into he will study the causes. The second important direction the Supreme Court said is, the police have a duty to disperse a mob. See, the major problem what happens is, the police inaction is fueled by the mob. So once the mob is dispersed, half the work is over. Third important direction the Supreme Court gave was, you broadcast, let the government broadcast on TV, radio and social media that lynching is a serious offense, and FIR will be registered against the persons responsible for spreading false information. See, this is an important thing. You enlighten the people on social media. Then you also, on social media, you get the names of you show the people involved in that, naming and shaming them. The Supreme Court also said, see, apart from the social media enlightening the people on the problems created by lynching, it said you look after the people who are affected. That's an important thing. That is, how will you compensate them, people who have undergone the trauma of the victim, the families? Then the Supreme Court also said, you have trial by a designated court within 6 months. Within 6 months, the case should be completed and the maximum punishment should be imposed on the official. Fixing responsibility on the district officials, whether it is the district magistrate, whether it is the superintendent of police, whether it is the subdivisional magistrate or the taluk magistrate, whoever, fixing responsibility. Then the next thing would be rewarding the performers and punishing the non-performing bureaucracy at all levels. See, this is a recommendation made by the second ARC. The second ARC clearly says performers at all levels should be rewarded. The non-performers who cannot perform, who will not deliver, they should be weeded out. There should be a periodic de-weeding of the bureaucracy at all levels. I mean, see, always we see the people at the lower levels are divided. What about the non-performers at the top level, at the secretary level? They also have to be removed. That is the non-performing staff. monitor social media and the press. There should be some mechanism in which the social media is held responsible, and they cannot be allowed to get away by fueling rumors and adding fuel to the fire. See, if we see the statistics, Muslims were victims in 60% of the hate crimes. So in this, what I would like to say is, I would not like to mention any caste or community. I would like to highlight that the vulnerable groups, whoever they are, whether it is the SC, the ST, the backward community, the minorities, the vulnerable groups, the differently abled, the aged, the children, the women, see, they all have to be taken care of. Suppose if they are obviously they are the victims of the family, so they have to be rehabilitated, and there should be a mechanism to address their trauma and to see that they are sufficiently rehabilitated. So for a question relating to, and finally, what you have to add in your answer, you have to say that the citizens or the mob cannot take upon itself the task of providing instant justice. The task of delivering justice, the task of maintaining law and order, is the responsibility of the government. The citizen cannot take the role of the government. So, concluding the answer, one more thing which I would like to suggest, especially when a question like this comes, don't be critical of the government. Don't bring in your personal agenda. Don't be critical of the government, because as a civil servant, you are supposed to implement the policies of the government. You cannot be critical of the government. See, what you can do, you give suggestions. The examiner appreciates suggestions. Don't be critical of the government. Don't, in your answer, don't side with any political party, whatever, whatever. So this particular question for 200 words, the introduction, you point out how it is a national phenomenon. It is not confined to Assam or anywhere else, though it accounts the highest incidence. It is there throughout the country. So why it is happening, you list the causes why it is happening. Then solutions, you list the solutions. You highlight the role of the second ARC. After you mention the 6-7 solutions, in the conclusion, you say how the second ARC speaks of rewarding the performers and punishing the non-performing bureaucracy. This is the most important thing. See, because the corrupt, inefficient and non-performing bureaucracy, whichever level it is, unless people are shown the door, the others will not fall in line, especially in the task of bringing the accused to book. The bureaucracy at all levels has to perform. So this will be the answer for this particular question. Thank you.